Good morning students, welcome back to Max online class. In the previous class you have learned the midpoint of a line segment. Today also I am going to explain the midpoint of a line segment. The previous class I have given two problem as homework. Have you all completed? Students, take your homework note and check the answers. Exercise 5.3, first one, first problem. Find the midpoint of the line segment joining the points minus 2, 3 and minus 6, minus 5. What's the formula for midpoint? In the previous class itself, I explained the formula for midpoint. What's the formula? x1 plus x2 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2. Given points minus 2, 3 and minus 6, minus 5. Here it is x1. x1 is equal to minus 2, y1 is equal to 3. x2 is equal to minus 6, y2 is equal to minus 5. Okay, midpoint formula, x1 plus x2 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2. Midpoint is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2. Here x1 in place minus 2, minus 2 plus x2 in place minus 6, minus 2 plus minus 6 by 2, y1 3 plus minus 5 by 2 is equal to here. Minus 2 plus minus 6 minus 8, minus 8 by 2, 3 plus minus 5 minus 2, minus 2 by 2 is equal to, here cancelling time minus 4, 1 2 is 2, 4 2 is right, here also 1 2 is 2, 1 2 is 2. So minus 4, minus 1 is the midpoint. Then the second problem, that is a homework problem. The center of a circle is minus 4, 2. If one end of the diameter of the circle is minus 3, 7, then find the other end. Listen here. One end is given minus 3, 7. That I am taking as A. Okay. AB is the diameter like that. I am taking that. Okay. Let A minus 3, 7. And the other end be BX, Y. Other end we have to find out. That I am taking as Y. XY. Okay. B is X, Y. Then the midpoint is given. Center is minus 4, 2. Center is minus 4, 2. One end is minus 3, 7. That I am taking as A. Next other end we have to find out. Center is given minus 4, 2. We know that the center of the diameter is midpoint of AB. Center of the diameter is midpoint of AB. Here center is given. Center is equal to minus 4, 2. Center is the midpoint of AB. You know that center is the midpoint. Center means the midpoint of AB. Midpoint of AB is equal to minus 4, 2. Here, x1 plus x2 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2 is equal to minus 4, 2. Next, x1 in place minus 3. Minus 3 plus x2 in place, what you have to put? x1 is equal to minus 3, y1 is equal to 7, x2 is equal to x, y2 is equal to y. So minus 3 plus x by 2, next y1 in place 7, 7 plus y by 2 is equal to minus 4, 2. Equating x and y coordinate, if you are equating the x and y coordinate, minus 3 plus x by 2. Minus 3 plus x by 2 is equal to minus 4. 7 plus y by 2 is equal to 2. So minus 3 plus x is equal to minus 8. X is equal to minus 8 plus 3 is equal to minus 5. Next, 7 plus y by 2 is equal to 2. 7 plus y is equal to 2. 2 is 4. Y is equal to 4 minus 7 is equal to minus 3. Therefore, the other end is equal to minus 5, minus 3. Next, now I am going to explain example 5.13. If x, 3, 6, y, 8, 2 and 9, 4 are the vertices of a parallelogram taken in order, then find the value of x and y. Please listen here. Parallelogram ABCD, I am taking as ABCD. ABCD. A, x, 3, B, 6, y, C 8, 2, D 9, 4. Okay. Let A, x comma 3. Let A x comma 3, B 6 comma y, C 8 comma 2, D 9 comma 4 be the vertices of a parallelogram. Vertices of a parallelogram. Here we want to find out the value of x and y. We know that in a parallelogram, the previous class itself we have learned that in a parallelogram, diagonal bisect each other. Okay. In a parallelogram, diagonal bisect each other. Okay. Therefore, the midpoint of AC is equal to midpoint of BD. Okay. By definition, diagonals of AC and by BD bisect each other. AC and BD bisect each other. Therefore, we can take midpoint of AC is equal to midpoint of BD. Midpoint of AC is equal to midpoint of BD. What is the midpoint of AC? Midpoint of AC. You know that midpoint formula is what? Midpoint is equal to formula. Midpoint is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Midpoint of AC means x plus 8 by 2. Okay. Where here x1 in place x, y1 in place 8. So x plus 8 by 2. Comma, next y1 plus y2 in place 3 plus 2 by 2 is equal to, next midpoint of BD means 6 plus 9 by 2 comma y plus here x1 6 y when the x2 9, so 6 plus 9 by 2 y1 y, so y plus 4 by 2. So x plus 8 by 2 comma 5 by 2, 3 plus 2 means 5 by 2 is equal to 6 plus 9, 15. 15 by 2 comma y plus 4 by 2. Clear? Have you all understand this? In a parallelogram, diagonal bisect each other. So we can take midpoint of AC is equal to midpoint of BD. If your midpoint of AC means x plus 8 by 2 comma 3 plus 2 by 2. Midpoint of BD means 6 plus 9 by 2 comma y plus 4 by 2. Okay, so we are getting x plus 8 by 2 comma 5 by 2 is equal to 15 by 2 comma y plus 4 by 2. Now, we can equate the x and y coordinate. Equating x and y coordinate. X plus 8 by 2 is equal to 15 by 2. 5 by 2 is equal to y plus 4 by 2 will be get. X plus 8 by 2 is equal to 15 by 2. 5 by 2 is equal to y plus 4 by 2. So equating x and y coordinate. X plus 8 by 2 is equal to 15 by 2. 5 by 2 is equal to y plus 4 by 2. Here, listen here. Here, denominator 2, 2 we can cancel it. Denominator 2, 2 we can cancel it. Here also denominator 2, 2 we can cancel it. Okay. So, we are getting x plus 8 is equal to 15. 15. X is equal to 15 minus 8. X is equal to 15 minus 8 means what will we get it? 15 minus 8 is equal to 7. X is equal to 7. Here also y plus 4 is equal to 5. 5 is equal to y plus 4 we can write. Y plus 4 is equal to 5. Y is equal to 5 minus 4 is equal to y is equal to 1. Therefore, the value of x is equal to 7, y is equal to 1. Therefore, x is equal to 7, y is equal to 1. Can you all understand this? Any doubt? Very easy problem, no? Have you all understand this? Okay. Next example, 5.14. Find the points which divide the line segment joining A minus 11 comma 4 and B 9 comma 8 into 4 equal parts. It's very important problem. It's a 5 mark problem. Listen, A, B is the line segment. That is minus 11 comma 4. B is 9 comma 8. We have to find out the line, find the point which divide the line segment into 4 equal parts. 4 equal parts means, listen here, how can we split this here off? Now we are getting this into 2 equal parts. If we are splitting in the middle, we will be get 2 equal parts. Okay. If you are splitting into middle, we will be get 2 equal parts. Again, we are splitting here into 2. We will be get 4 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. If you want to find out the 4 equal parts, first we have to find out the midpoint of AB. Next, that we can take here P, Q, R. Okay. 4 equal parts, we can take it P, Q, R like that. We can take it P, Q, R. Okay. Midpoint of AB is equal to Q. Next, midpoint of AQ is equal to P. Next, midpoint of QB is equal to R. Now we can take, let P, Q, R be the points. These are the points on the line segment. Joining A minus 11 comma 4, B 9 comma 8 such that AP is equal to PQ is equal to QR is equal to RB. Now, Q is the midpoint of AB. Q is the midpoint of AB. Therefore, Q is equal to midpoint formula. First, we can write the midpoint formula. Midpoint is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Now, Q is the midpoint of AB. Midpoint is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Now, listen here. Q is equal to what will be get? Q is the midpoint of AB. X1 in place, what you want to take? Minus 11. X1 is equal to minus 11. Y1 is equal to 4. X2 is equal to 9. Y2 is equal to 8. So, Q is equal to minus 11 plus 9. X1 in place minus 11. Minus 11 plus 9 by 2, comma Y1 in place 4 plus 8 by 2. So, is equal to minus 2 by 2, comma 12 by 2. It's equal to minus 1, comma 6. Therefore, Q point is minus 1 comma 6. Q is equal to minus 1 comma 6. Now 1 point we have find out. Next we have to find out P and R. What is P? P is the midpoint of AQ. P is the midpoint of AQ. Listen here. Then P is the midpoint of AQ. A point is what is A? X1, Y1. A point is X1, Y1. That is minus 11 comma 4. Next, x2 comma y2 in place. Minus 1 comma 6. Minus 1 comma 6. So p is equal to x1 in place minus 11 plus minus 1 by 2 comma y1 in place 4 plus 6 by 2 is equal to minus 12 by 2 comma 10 by 2. 6, 5. So p is equal to minus 6 comma 5. Next we have to find out the point R. R is the midpoint of which one? QB. R is the midpoint of QB. Here x1 is equal to x1 y1, what is that? Q point is x1 y1. Q point is what is that? Q point is minus 1 comma 6, is it? Before that we have find out. So x1 is equal to minus 1, y1 is equal to 6. Next b point is what? B point is 9 comma 8. So x2 is equal to 9, y2 is equal to 8. Therefore, R is equal to minus 1 plus 9 by 2 comma 6 plus 8 by 2 is equal to 8 by 2 comma 14 by 2. So, it's equal to 4 comma 7. It's equal to 4 comma 7. So, now already we have find out. Q is the midpoint of AB. So Q we are getting minus 1 comma 6. Next what's that? P is the midpoint of, P is the midpoint of AQ. So P is equal to, P is equal to minus 6 comma 5. R is the midpoint of QB. So R we are getting 4 comma 7. Therefore the point which divides points which divides AB into four equal parts are P minus 6 comma 5, Q minus 1 comma 6 and R 4 comma 7. Clear? Any doubt in here? Any doubt? No doubt, no? Now I am going to explain example 5.15. The midpoints of the sides of a triangle are 5 comma 1, 3 comma minus 5 and minus 5 comma minus 1. Find the coordinates of the vertices of the triangle. We have to find out the coordinates of the vertices of the triangle. Please listen here. About 5 mark question it is. A, B, C. Here, the midpoints of the sides of the triangle given. What is given? Midpoints of the sides of the triangle is given. Midpoint of A, B is 5, 1. Midpoint of A, B is A, B, C. Midpoint of AB is 5 comma 1 like that given. Next, midpoint of BC we can take 3 comma minus 5. Next, midpoint of AC is given minus 5 comma minus 1. Okay, 3, the midpoints of the sides of triangles are given. We want to find out the ABC. The question is, we have to find out the ABC. Now we can take left, the vertices of triangle ABC are, let the vertices of triangle ABC are ABC be A x1 comma y1, B x2 comma y2, C x3 comma y3. Here it is x1 comma y1. Here we are taking x2 comma y2. C is we can take x3 comma y3. Clear? A, B, C, like the 3 points we are taking that. What's the formula for midpoint? Say the formula for midpoint. Midpoint M is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Okay, x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Now, midpoint of AB is equal to 5 comma 1. What is given? Midpoint of AB is equal to 5 comma 1. Please listen here. Midpoint of AB means x1 plus x2 by 2 comma two is equal to 5, like that we can take x1 plus x2 by 2 is equal to 5, y1 plus y2 by 2 is equal to 1. Okay, x1 plus x2 by 2 is equal to 5, y1 plus y2 is equal to y2 by 2 is equal to 2. If you are cross multiplying, what will be get? X1 plus x2 is equal to 5 to 10, y1 plus y2 is equal to 2. 1, 2 is 2. Clear? Any doubt? Here it is equation 1, like that take it. It is equation 2. Next, midpoint of BC is equal to 3, comma minus 5. Midpoint of BC is equal to 3, comma minus 5. So, midpoint of BC means x2 plus x3 by 2, is it? X2 plus x3 by 2 is equal to 3. X2 plus x3 by 2 is equal to 3. Next, y2 plus y3 by 2 is equal to minus 5. Okay. X2 plus x3 by 2 is equal to 3. Y2 plus y3 by 2 is equal to minus 5. So, from here, what will we get? X2 plus x2, x3 is equal to 6. Y2 plus y3 is equal to minus 10. From here, we are getting x2 plus x3 is equal to 6. Next, y2 plus y3 is equal to, y2 plus y3 is equal to minus 10. This equation 3. Here, we can take equation 4. Clear? Next, we can take that. What is given next from this diagram? Please listen here. Midpoint of AC is equal to minus 5 comma minus 1. So, midpoint of AC like that taking time? X1 plus X3 by 3. Midpoint of AC is equal to minus 5 comma minus 1. That means x1 plus x3 by 2. X1 plus x3 by 2 is equal to which one? Minus 5. Y1 plus y3 by 2 is equal to minus 1. From this what we can take it? X1 plus x3 is equal to 5 to 10 minus 10. Plus into minus minus 5 to 10 minus 10. Next, y1 plus y3 is equal to 1 2 is 2 minus 2. It is equation 5. It is equation 6. Clear? Okay. Now, x1 plus what is equation 1? X1 plus x2 is equal to 10. Next, equation 2 is which one? Equation 2 is. Equation 3 is x2 plus x3 is equal to 6. Next, equation 5 is y1 plus y3 is equal to minus 10. When we are adding 1 plus 3 plus 5, what will we get? 1 plus 3 plus 5 implies x1 plus x2 is equal to 10. Next, x2 plus x3 is equal to 6. Next, x1 plus x3 is equal to minus 10. This 3 also we have to add. So x1 plus x1 means 2x1. Next x2 plus x2 means 2x2. X3 plus x3 means 2x3 is equal to 16 minus 10, 6. So x1 plus here dividing by 2, what will we get each time dividing by 2? X1 plus x2 plus x3 is equal to which one? 3. X1 plus x2 plus every term we can divide it by 2. So x1 plus x2 plus x3 is equal to 3. Next, substitute x1 plus x2 is equal to x1 plus x2 value equation 1. What is getting? 10. In which equation? 7. We can substitute in 7. If you are substituting x1 plus x2 in place 10, what will be get? 10 plus x3 is equal to 3. X3 is equal to 3 minus 10 is equal to minus 7. Now we are getting x3 is equal to minus 7. Now substitute x3 is equal to minus 7 in 5. So x1 plus, in the equation 5, what is? X1 plus x3 is equal to minus 10. If we substitute x3 is equal to minus 10, minus 7, minus 10. So what we are getting? X1 is equal to, x1 is equal to, x1 is equal to minus 10 plus 7. X1 is equal to minus 3. Now we are getting x1 is equal to minus 3. Then if we substitute x1 value, x1 is equal to minus 3 in equation 1. If we substitute x1 is equal to minus 3 in equation 1, what will we get? If we substitute x1 is equal to minus 3 in 1, what will we get? What is the equation 1? X1 plus x2 is equal to 10. So x1 in place minus 3 plus x2 is equal to 10. So x2 is equal to 10 plus 3 is equal to 13. So x2 value is 13. Therefore we are getting x1 is equal to minus 3. X2 is equal to 13. Next x3 is equal to minus 7. Any doubt? Similarly we have to add 2 plus 4 plus 6. Adding 2 plus 4 plus 6 implies. Okay, we have to add 2 plus 4 plus 6 implies. What will we get? Listen here. Equation 2 is y1 plus y2 is equal to 2. Next, y1 plus y2 is equal to 2. Next, equation 2 is, 4 is what? Y2 plus y3 is equal to minus 10. Next, equation 6 is what? Equation 6, y1 plus y3 is equal to minus 2. When we are adding 2y1, okay, y1 plus y1 means 2y1 plus 2y2 plus 2y3 is equal to, here minus 10 will be get. Next here also we can dividing by 2. What will be get? Y1 plus y2 plus y3 is equal to minus 5. This we can take equation 8. Now substitute here equation 2 is y1 plus y2 is equal to 2. Same like that before what we did, the same method. Y1 plus y2 is equal to 2 in equation 8. In equation 8, in this place where we can substitute 2. Y1 plus y2 in place 2. 2 plus y3 is equal to minus 5. Therefore, y3 is equal to minus 5 minus 2 is equal to minus 7. We are getting y3 is equal to minus 7. We are getting y3 is equal to minus 7. Then substitute y3 is equal to minus 7 in equation 6. What is equation 6? Equation 6 is y1 plus y3 is equal to minus 2. So y1 plus y3 in place minus 7 is equal to minus 2. So y1 is equal to minus 2 plus 7 is equal to 5. Next, substitute y1 is equal to 5 in equation 2. Substitute this y1 is equal to 5 in equation 2. What is equation 2? What is equation 2? y1 plus y2 is equal to 2. y1 in place 5 plus next y2 is equal to 2. Therefore, y2 is equal to 2 minus 5 is equal to minus 3. So y2 is equal to minus 3. We got it 3 points. y1 is equal to 5. Next y2 is equal to minus 3. Next y3 is equal to minus 7. So we got it 3 points also. 3 coordinates A, B, C we have find out. Therefore A is what? Therefore the vertices of the triangle are what is A point? X1, Y1. X1 is what? Minus 3. Y1 is 5. So, minus 3, 5. B is X2, Y2. So, 13, minus 3. Next, C is, what's that? C is X3, Y3. So, minus 7, minus 7. These are the 3 points of the 3 coordinates of the vertices of a triangle are A minus 3 5, B 13 minus 3, C minus 7 minus 7. Exercise 5.3. Fourth problem homework. Only one problem homework. Students do the homework problem. Revise all the portions, learn the formula, everything. If you learn the formula means only you can do the problem. This problem exercise 5.3, fourth problem is same like the example 5.15. Now we have completed. Can you do that? Okay, students, please do the homework problem. Thank you, students.